I would like to acknowledge the Wurundjeri people as the traditional owners of the land where I currently live in Ringwood East, Victoria. I would also like to acknowledge the Wajuk people of the Noongar Nation in Western Australia, as I spent a lot of my life growing up there in Beckenham, Western Australia. Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders are warned that this presentation may contain images or voices of those who are deceased. I also warn that one image may cause distress to viewers as it contains a picture of Indigenous peoples during colonisation. For this assignment, I have chosen to focus on question 3 and look at an Indigenous Australian artist named Megan Cope. I found her contemporary art to be really interesting, both in what she's producing as an artist and the topics she has chosen to explore within her artwork. Cope has focused on exploring the ongoing impact of colonisation on the Indigenous peoples of Australia in the many social issues that they face now, in the future, and further into their history. Cope has also looked at the impact of colonisation on her own family's history and the ways that this has impacted her identity and her sense of belonging as an Indigenous Australian woman in today's climate. Using her strong connection to her Kwandamuka heritage, she has woven the traditional stories from her elders into her current art explorations. Cope is using these different methods and art practices to start breaking down the obvious marks of colonisation by playing with text, paint, video work, sculpture, and site-specific installations, bringing all these together to make her mark. The colonisation of Australia was a devastating time for the Indigenous people that lived here happily for over 60,000 years. When the Europeans arrived in this land and declared it terra nullius, they took away more than just land. Too many Indigenous Australians lost their lives protecting what was theirs. Entire communities were wiped out, languages were lost, and their connections to sacred places severed. Generations of children were stolen from their families, losing all connection to their Indigenous heritage. The history of Indigenous Australia was wiped clean from the map. An entire nation of people gone in one foul action. The colonisation of this country continues to this day to affect our Indigenous Australians, as they are still fighting against the disconnection from land that we make them face and the struggles with their own identity, all caused by the displacement of the Indigenous peoples. Megan Cope is one Indigenous Australian artist who is not afraid of stepping on some toes and displacing some complacent racism as she unravels Australia's long history of European colonisation and oppression of the Indigenous peoples of this nation. One of Cope's main themes when making her artwork is colonisation's direct impact in the loss of the Indigenous lands and languages, when Europeans first claimed and renamed Indigenous lands, highlighting the fact that the dominant language of Australia, both written and verbal, is European-based language. Cope is showing us that the use of Australia's Indigenous language, the language that was rightly here first, is completely lacking from our landscape and our lives due to the direct displacement of the Indigenous peoples. One way Cope is starting to break down the dominant impact of this European language and the European mark, and to move onwards from colonisation, is to insert her Indigenous language and the Indigenous languages of this nation back into the land, to call the spaces and sacred places by their traditional names, the names that they were first given. Cope reuses old maps from the 1920s, 1950s that were designed and named by the Europeans. She then edits them by painting in the Indigenous place names and takes away the European mark by turning it back into what it was originally named. As you can see by these examples of her pictures, the language becomes the dominant feature on the map. Cope is also hoping it will reaffirm their place as the first people of this country. by taking away the now familiar to us. It will also instill into the viewer the same feelings of displacement and loss of claimed land that was felt by the Indigenous Australians during colonisation. Taking away the place we know and have memories attached to, Cope is provoking the same emotional responses the Indigenous Australians experienced and still experience when reacting to their loss of home and displacement from land. Cope also uses this reclaiming of language to produce site-specific installations all over Australia, where she projects the Indigenous name of the monument or area onto the place itself. It is putting the viewer right into the reclaiming of land and reminding them in this very moment that this will always be Indigenous land. Cope has also responded to the colonisation of Australia on a more personal level in her artwork. Her experiences growing up as a fair-skinned, blue-eyed girl of mixed European Aboriginal heritage had always stood out to other people but never really impacted the way she saw herself as an Indigenous Australian woman. Constantly being questioned by outsiders that she wasn't black enough to be Indigenous had never really made her question her identity. Being raised by her Indigenous single father already broke the stereotypical views that were cast upon them, and for that she was proud. Cope had grown up with the stories and memories from her grandparents and elders and always strongly connected to her Indigenous family. It was only when Cope had to gain her Aboriginal certification to work overseas that it got her wondering if indeed she was black enough to be Aboriginal. It hit her on a deeply emotional level that really made her question her own identity as an Indigenous Australian. Cope's struggle with these essentialist views of looking Indigenous, combined with the absurdity of having to prove her Indigenous heritage, prompted Cope to look at the way we are still grouping people on their skin colour and judge their social status or means upon their visual race. Cope's personal conflict of being Indigenous but not stereotypically looking Indigenous made her question the way we, as a society, still view our Indigenous Australians. This essentialist view that you must be black to be Aboriginal really, really needed to be erased from our society. Cope, in response, created a visual piece named the Blacktism. Using this ritualistic ceremony, Cope officially baptizes herself as a certified black Aboriginal woman. She darkens her skin with clay and dons darker contact lenses. Cope is challenging the stereotypical representations of being a dark-skinned Indigenous Australian after European colonisation. Cope has clearly shown us that colonisation is still impacting how we view and treat our Indigenous peoples. The oversaturation of the Europeans' mark needs to be lifted from this country so our Indigenous peoples can re-establish their stronghold as the first peoples of this country. By allowing their language to become equal, if not dominant, it will start to shift the power back to the Indigenous Australians. One day, I hope we can give our first peoples the proper amount of respect and authority over this land that they truly deserve. When Indigenous artists and thinkers like Megan Cope use their Indigenous heritage to challenge our essentialist views of Indigenous Australians, it creates honest conversation about the colonisation of this country, the bloodshed the Indigenous Australians went through, and the reclaiming of stolen Indigenous lands. Only by admitting our past, we can begin to reshape the future.